Now let's go ahead and define function again. Function is a relation or rule from a set x to a set y in which every element of x is mapped to exactly one element of y. Sometimes this rule can come in the form of an equation, which we haven't seen thus far. So for example, we're going to take the relation f of x equals 3x minus 2. And so what that rule is basically saying is you're starting with the independent variable x, you're tripling it, and then you're subtracting off 2, and you're getting a resultant output, which is your f of x. So let's go ahead and start with any input that's within our domain of our function. So let's say we start with the input negative 2. And we go ahead and we apply our rule where we triple and then subtract off 2. And we get the output negative 8. We do the same. We take the negative 1 as our input. Again, triple it, subtract off 2, and we get negative 5. Take our input 0, triple it, subtract off 2, we get negative 2. And take our input 1, triple it, subtract off 2, we get 1. And take 2, triple it, subtract off 2, we get 4. And so these are not all of the ordered pairs that result from this rule, but these are some of them. And so then what I would do is I would go ahead and take each one of those graphically and I'd plot them. And so after I plot each one of them, I'd see that they form this straight line, and I'd go ahead and connect the dots, because again, it's not just those individual points that are part of this relation, it's all of the points. And so we need to make sure that we connect the points so that we get the representation of all of the infinite number of points that this equation makes. And so that is what's represented here by this line. Now the question becomes, is this relation a function? Well, from the graph, you could apply the vertical line test, and we would see that if we drew a vertical line anywhere on the graph, no matter what, we only intersect the graph at most one point. So like I drew a vertical line here, and on I go. Even if I do all the way out here, that line's extending out. So I'm still only hitting the graph at most one time. And so we can see that this passes the vertical line test, and so this relation is a function. Another way to see that this equation is a function is when we look at the table of values, we could see that no matter what we picked for the input, that input only went to one particular output. And that makes sense. If you triple number and then subtract off 2, you're going to get a single value. You're not going to get any other value. And so that is why this equation is a function.